Here is this power supply for the cordless. As you can see, one leg has been broken for this one, and this is of course Panasonic, something 500 milliampere, and the voltage is of course 9 volt, as you can see here. So this power supply we are going to repair. What we are going to do is we are going to make this leg, we are going to repair this leg, as the leg had been broken and they had brought. So I will repair that leg and we'll solder it over here, but we will solder it and we will reinforce it so that it will not come off once again as it is. This had been repaired before also. You can see the repair attempt is there. You can see this epoxy, these things, they have been put sometimes before me. So we are going to repair it. And why this repair is, because they are not very much expensive, they are cheap devices, but sometimes you have something special, as in this case it's not special, it's just ordinary, but sometimes they have special connections or some special voltages. So you are going to repair it, that's why I'm going to show you in this video. In my case it's not any special. I will use some ordinary tools, and here is the flux. You can see this is the Clofany flux. Actually I'm going to put a little bit flux to make it this will ease my soldering actually. So I just put a little quantity of flux, and now I'm going to solder it. The way I'm soldering it, first I will make a blob of solder over here, something like this, so this is enough solder, you can see. And here of course, as you can see, there is a solder, but I will put a little bit of Clofany as a flux so that it will be ready to solder. And of course this piece I will not grab in my hand, because this will become very much hot during soldering process. So I'm holding it in pliers and then soldering it over here. As you can see, I'm providing heat, and enough heat so that it will be soldered perfectly on the base. But the thing is, I have to tin it a little bit so that it will be embedded perfectly inside the solder. So something like this, as you can see, now it had been soldered. I will check its strength using my pliers, because it's hot, enough hot, I cannot hold it. So you can see it's enough strong, I cannot wiggle it. I'm trying to, but it's not easy to come off. So it's perfectly soldered. Yeah, it's even not rotating. So by this way, as you can see, this is soldered and it's perfect. Now it will not come off again as it was. What I will instruct them, they can put some epoxy over here as it was before. You can see epoxy will reinforce a little bit, it will not help more, because soldering is enough. So I'm going to test this device. I'm going to electrify and then we'll test it over here and we'll confirm the health. So just connect it to the mains, and here is my automotive tester. I'm using very frequently on automotive. This tester is at 12 volt, but it can start from 3.3 volt somewhere. And here are two terminals. One is this outer, this will be the negative, and the inner, of course, this will be the positive. So I'm going to connect negative and positive and looking for the tester. As you can see this tester is glowing. This light is illuminating, means there is power and this is working well. Now you can see the power supply repair. This was actually the soldering tutorial which I just show you, but it will help to the people who are about to fix they are on power supplies by this way. It was not a professional repair, instead it was a very simple and a die repair. Thank you for watching, keep on watching and stay tuned, like, subscribe.